Yo, what is going on, guys? Bishop's Gaming here, and today I just wanted to talk you through the rituals. I think it's a lot of confusion around them. I know a lot of people couldn't do them. We just randomly come across it, and we're kind of working it out as we played on this gameplay. So hope you guys enjoy it. Anyway, I'm not going to talk over all the gameplay because it is quite long, but I will show you all the rituals throughout this gameplay and talk to you about how you can get them and how you can unlock them. So basically, what you need to pick up is the championship belt, the fountain pen, the hairpiece, and the badge, one for each character. It doesn't matter who picks up what though. That doesn't matter at all. This basically unlocks the pack a punch down into the rift. So basically, what you want to go to each places. So you've got the gym here, you've got the burlesque building over the other side, the theater, and the rooftop building above the spawn where you spawn in at the start. And basically, it will cost you a lot to open all the doors to get to each place, and sometimes after completing the ritual, a Magawa or Magwa will spawn after the ritual is completed, but not always. As you can see on this first one, that one doesn't spawn at all. But basically, what you want to do is you want to either survive, or you can just run around and run away from these things, survive the time limit, or you can kill them, it doesn't really matter. Just to make sure you survive throughout the whole thing, and then you want to pick up a blue ball that will spawn on the ritual table. That will always help you. The ritual places I've already told you. This basically unlocks Pack-a-Punch at the end, if you didn't know. So you go down into the rift and Pack-a-Punch will unlock for you, so you can basically upgrade your weapons. It does take a lot to upgrade your weapons. What happens is you place your little maggots you get down, is what you get from completing each ritual. Each person gets a maggot. You put that down, and then you put it into some little pot, and in that pot will spawn like the wall run. You can run the wall one over, and there'll be two other ones where the other two players can put it down. I think you do need four people to do this, so you can put down the final two, and then pack a punch will unlock. As you can see in this video towards the end, that we actually die whilst doing it, but it was our first time, so we haven't really had the chance to have a go at ourselves. What we were doing, we were kind of just thinking about doing it, and I don't really know. I'm unlocking it ourselves in our heads whilst we were playing, so we didn't really know what was going on. But yeah, this is just another ritual. I think you'll see at the end of this one here that a Magwa will destroy. Sorry if the quality is a little bit bad, I was streaming at the same time. So if you guys don't know already, I stream every single day when this Call of Duty is out. So if you want to watch me on Twitch, it's Bishop's Gaming on Twitch. So just search me in and watch my videos. That'd be great. So basically, it doesn't matter who puts what down. Who picks what up, but it matters who puts what down in what location. Each person will have a location, so the big boxer guy will obviously be the gym, the magician will be the theater, up the top here will be the investigator, and down the into the burlesque building is the woman, and you have to make sure that they put them down in that place. Otherwise you can't, you're not allowed. It doesn't let the other person do it. Obviously you see here the Magwa's dart outspawned here, and we're obviously just going to train it around in there and kill it. It's probably best to keep a crawler, because if you had zombies coming at you, I think this would be really, really, really hard. So I recommend having a crawler. But yeah, you'll see at the end that this new area in the rift will open, and there'll be symbols on the wall, and once you've opened all that, you can put your maggots down, run across, and get the pack a punch. So here's the next area. This is the theater area, and obviously the ritual place is on the stage. Bishop's gonna put it down now, and loads of them will spawn. You can just run away, or you can shoot them. I prefer to shoot them because they annoy me if they hit me. But yeah, anyway, this has been Bishop's Game, and I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you watch to the end, you'll see how we completed every single one, and then where to go for Pack-a-Punch. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. This new map is definitely by far the most awesome. I don't know, it's definitely the best zombies gameplay I've played in a long time. So yeah, if you guys have enjoyed this, please leave a like. Obviously follow me on Twitch, or watch my videos on Twitch, because I'll be playing a lot of Call of Duty over the next couple of days. So yeah, I'll see you all guys in the next video.